All right now we're going to be talking with the CR, my partner in the website Panda Investment Strategies, and we are going to talk right now with the CR about the trading room and some other thoughts. How are you doing, CR?
Panda, first of all, congratulations on another win for October, the option service. That was terrific.
Yeah, it wasn't bad. You know, we keep doing it and we keep trying to maintain profits throughout the year and throughout month by month, and that you are also going to offer some great services, and as we go through this video we'll be able to talk a little bit about those. So let's go right ahead. What are we looking at right now?
Well, before I begin, I wanted to point out how Bamboo did. You're one of your premier strategies for trading E-mini. We've been in the Panda's den for 2 weeks now. We started 2 weeks ago, and we've been highlighting Bamboo in the heat service and that particular methodology. And I just ran this auto test, a back test of the Panda Bamboo auto system on last week's data on NT. And this just shows what kind of profits are Bamboo is capable of pulling. They had 13 trades, 10 winners, and 3 losers. That is on fire.
And so how many contracts was that
ex
trading?
Commissions, it made 400. This was a one contract, $400 on one contract.
Yeah. Yeah, so, you
know,
that's
pretty cool.
Yeah, the Bamboo's a slow trader, but, you know, it seems to be working, and we're glad that those who are using it are profiting from it. So that's how we do it. We keep it simple, and we keep trying to make little ticks.
And if you want to do it a little faster, you can use the heat. And I've been watching you in the room, and I've been observing the heat.
I love the heat.
And the method.
Heat is awesome.
Making points.
The heat is on fire, so that's all I can say. And I am looking into having that automated. I've just been busy. You've been busy doing a lot of things here in the room, and so yeah. But we have good things going forward, and we're excited for the progress in the business, in the site, and for traders and making profits.
Yeah. Well, anyone that's interested in scalping points, I really encourage you to get with Panda for his Bamboo system and check out the heat if you like to be even more active. Mm-hmm. We've been using them in the den, and I've seen them at work, and I can vouch for them. At the same time, I've been using my own approach, which involves buying pullbacks rather than taking breakout trades. And I've been trying to manage all three strategies, Panda, and it's been a little challenging.
Yeah, I'm sure. I'm sure, definitely. Especially, you know, since you're just, you know, pretty much new to trading with the live room environment, you know, and plus maybe having a little bit of pressure from the other people and stuff like that. So, yeah, I mean, it's definitely a new experience, you know, jumping into. So what are your thoughts on it?
Well, after juggling those three systems and realizing that my focus is trading pullbacks, which is what I'm most comfortable with, even though Bamboo and Heat have been working well, you have to trade, and you know, new or aspiring traders are going to find this out, that you have to do what you feel best and most comfortable with.
Absolutely.
And this is just what I'm most natural at. So I actually tendered my resignation to Panda because I didn't feel I was doing his room justice. But much to my surprise, he asked me to stay on and just focus on what I enjoy doing so I can do it better, because trying to do more than one thing, you can't do anything well. So I wasn't able to do myself justice or Panda. So
yeah,
what we're going to be doing is focusing on the pitchfork analysis with Elliott Wave. And I just thought I would give people a little sneak peek of some of the trades that we picked. I use a kind of a unique approach on using the lines, and in the room what we're looking for is the current market resonance or harmonic. And this was on the 7th, and we were looking for this low here off this quartile, and we called this in the room as a long. And after the room closed, I was looking at this upper median line as a place to get out, and you can see right to the tick how that worked. And then the next day, I was looking for the quartile again. And lo and behold, pre-market, I wasn't around my screen, but it touched to the tick. So this is the type of trade location we're aspiring to capture in the markets. And you can see very clearly using these very interesting and special tools developed by Dr. Andrews, if they're applied correctly, it is possible to do that. And a couple other trades I just wanted to show you, which are pretty exciting. On Thursday, we were able to determine the current market harmonic using the line, and in the afternoon we have this trade appear right at the quartile, which these lines will predict. So
yeah, you know that name. I really like that name.
That's some of the stuff that's going on.
Market harmonics. It really sounds really true to the test and true to the look of the market, you know, that it follows these you know, levels and, you know, certain patterns that are harmonic in nature. Interesting.
Yeah, absolutely. The market has a frequency, and the idea is to figure out what that frequency is and trade in harmony with it. And that's what we're trying to do in the room. So for people that are swing traders or position traders, I mean, you know, you look at what we're, the kind of moves that we're looking at capturing here, you know, this could be just for you. And also, for those that are looking for more action, we can use the same principles. I'm not going to use the lines here because I'm going to show you some turning points, which is what we're looking for. Some turning points that appeared on Friday. This turning point right here was a basic trade off from one of the lines. And if you were there to take that at 9:30, you would have had just about the high on the day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Some more entries right here, 73. We normally front run our turning points by one tick because we often get them to the tick. So we have problems getting filled if we don't lead them by a tick, and you're my witness to that, aren't you, Panda?
It happened, yeah, it happened a bunch of times this week, you know, so definitely it's highly recommended just to get in sometimes if you want to, even a little bit early, because these lines are real and they work and they can bank several points in profit often.
Panda, this trade right here, 70.25, that was the most obvious trade of the day.
Nice.
At least the most obvious trade of the morning. And target one would have been 67. Our target two was 64. And reverse here. And that would have ended up working out pretty good. So
yeah.
We're going to be, now that we aren't juggling so many pins, we're going to be looking at focusing a little bit more. Maybe we can get a little sharper and not just, you know, checking out the larger swing trades, but also I'm hoping that we have the energy and time and focus now to, you know, look at the shorter time frames and try to satisfy the more active trader.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that's what we're looking at doing going forward. So I invite anybody who is interested in this type of trading, looking for high probability turning points, trading market harmonics, and using these tools to join us in Panda's Den. This is CR, and I look forward to seeing you there.
All right. Yeah, thanks a lot, CR, and that's why I have you on board here, because you are one of the top traders that I have witnessed, and true to your nature, you stick to your trading plan, just like how perhaps the Panda Bamboo and the Panda Heat didn't necessarily fit your particular trading style, while also at the same time trying to do your own method. So what you have chosen to do is the right thing, is that of sticking to what you do best. And in our trading room, we hope to instill those qualities in other traders to continue their career path in this. So I do appreciate that.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Panda.